I plead the blood of Holy Yahushua over this video and over the mind, body, and spirit of every child of Yah watching this video in Yahushua HaMashiach's holy name. Shalom, Shabbat Shalom, and welcome back to Wakefulness Theology. My name is Messenger Aaliyah Ora, and I'm so happy to continue this work. May the Most High Father's will be done, and may it be done in His name for His glory and for His honor. So let's not delay. Let's just keep going. The next holy letter that we're talking about today, the next letter in Holy Yahushua's name is Ayin. And it means I is from the tribe of Judah. The code is 1616. And as you can see on the screen, it is talking about zeal, our zeal, us being earnest travelers, and us being in the world, but not of the world. And this is so miraculous how this is happening, how line by line, we are literally living through this. So I pray that you at home who are watching these videos, I pray that you're experiencing these miracles with us at Wakefulness Theology. We're literally living these lines week by week. And this is representative of what is going to be happening to the entire manifested body of Christ, the actual true church, the remnant church that will be, that is in the process of manifesting, and that will be here and fully mature and in doing their jobs around the time of 2025. So at that time, these elements that we're living through individually, we're also going to be going through as a body. So this is amazing to actually be living this. For those who have been following along, Yah bless you. I pray that you have been able to grow with us. For those who are new to this channel, please catch up. This is the only way that you're going to understand what I'm going to talk about in this video today. If you don't catch up, you're going to be like, oh, this is new age. You're going to think, oh, this is crazy, or, oh, you're not going to understand. It's going to be foreign to you. You're going to lean on your own understanding and you're going to miss the blessing. I'm telling you right now, if you really want to understand what we're talking about, please be obedient and catch up. Look at this video right here. This is a video, a welcome video that we did. It's at the top of the playlist and it explains what wakefulness theology is. And then you can go to the website and here you see all the videos. We put all of our videos in playlists. And so you can catch up and you can understand how the Most High Father is working and how he is teaching us and how the Holy Spirit is teaching us this information. We're not getting it from man. We're not getting it from the internet. We're not getting it from books. We're getting it directly from the Most High Father. So thank you for being obedient and going back and catching up on this beautiful, sacred manna that Father has blessed us with. Holy Spirit is also teaching us how to war with our fingers. Not only that, I have understood recently that this is these holy letters that we're doing. This is the configuration of our souls. I've mentioned this before, but I haven't had a chance to explain it. I'm not going to explain it this week. I'll be explaining it in the subsequent videos. But I just want you to understand these holy letters that make up Holy Yahushua's name. These holy letters here that we're learning with the hand movements. This is representing and making up the configuration of our soul as we are belonging to Holy Yahushua. Okay? We are his children, okay? We are his servants, okay? So we'll be seeing that very soon. But as we go through these hand movements, please understand that this is what we're doing. We are manifesting the name of Holy Yahushua, okay? And this is the ultimate weapon because the enemy cannot stand before the Most High Father, his blood, or his name. His name is the key. It is the key of David, as we have understood last week, and we will talk about more today. I'm going to teach you the new hand movement that was given to me in prayer. The hand movement for Semach was given to me in prayer, and this hand movement of Ayin was also given to me in prayer. So you start with your hand like this, and you turn your hand backwards, you see? You turn your hand backwards and it goes down, it goes down like you're closing something. And then you turn your hands and it comes out. You bring it back to you, comes out again, turns back in. And here you're going to turn your hands back around and it goes up. So now when you're doing this, remember you're also doing your breathing. So here when you're doing this, you're breathing in. When you're doing this, you're breathing out. And you're breathing in again and you're breathing out. Okay, so with your hand, you're breathing in and out. And so as you can see, with our hands, our first movement is here, right? Our first movement is here and you can see the crown and everything here. Like our fingers, you know, it's kind of like here's the church, here's the steeple, open the door and see all the people, right? It's kind of like that. You have your right here, your crown, when you're doing this, okay? And so this is coming down and this is this first leg, and then when you go like this, that's this part right here, okay? And then you're coming back. So you're doing this right here. And then when you go up again, you're doing this second leg. So with our hands, we're doing the two legs of this letter, Ayin, and our fingers are the crown. Okay, so again, I'm given this movement without knowing what the letter is. And then after I'm given the movement, then I can go back and look at the letter and it just makes sense. Okay, so we're gonna go through all of them What Father has explained to me or shown me is that I'm going to produce some music, and we're going to, at the end of this playlist, we're going to do the hand movements with the music. You at home, you can already start to stand up and do these movements with your breathing and with worship music or whatever you have. This is what we're leading up to. It will be very much like a dance by time we're done. A king is learning feet movements. Priestess Yasmin Ella Shekinah is also learning hand movements, and we're going to put all these things together and we'll be ready to do it at the end of this playlist. So let's start. Okay, so that's where we are so far. Now this last movement of Ayin, for me, when I'm doing it, Holy Yahushua has had me do it at the end of my prayers, and it just feels like a closing, a completion of something. He had me do this movement when I told you of the experience that I had of going into the avatar state. And I told you at the end of that experience, I had to close the portal, because I felt like it was open and I felt interference coming. And so that is the hand movement he had me do to close the portal. So that is how I closed the portal inside of myself. I did this hand movement here. And it just feels like everything is being put in alignment and everything is being closed, right? That's what it felt like to me. Of course, pray on it, take it to the Holy Father, get your own confirmations, but that's what Holy Yahushua had me do to close my portal myself after I went into the avatar state. And I felt great after that. I felt warm and as cozy, as safe as a baby in a bundle, and I went right to sleep. So there you go, Ayin, hand movement. There's a lot to talk about this week. We have been given the key of David, and we have been taught how to use it, and we have begun using it this week. We also have received more information about chakras and how they are our seals, and how our seals are our keys, how we are to use them. So I'm going to be explaining that today. So let's start with the crown. I'm just realizing this right now, presenting this to you, that I see that there is the crown here on Ayin. And I knew that it was on noon. Right? This is Holy Yahushua, representing Holy Yahushua. And so I knew he has his crown. But here you can see this is when we receive our crown. And we receive our crowns because we are zealous and we are travelers and we are in the world but not of the world. And when you reach this point, this is when you receive your crown. So let's look at zeal and the crown. As usual, what I'm explaining to you is not theoretical. This is literally what we're living through. I was crowned. I received my crown from Holy Yahushua last year. I didn't share it with anyone. I didn't tell anybody. I didn't have a reason to. When I share something, it's because it's a part of a message and I need to share it. If I don't need to share it, I keep it to myself. So last year, I was praying. I was on my knee and Holy Yahushua came up behind me and he placed a crown on my head. And he also, I don't remember if it was the same time or a separate time, but at some point, he also put a cloak over me. So that was an experience that happened to me when I was praying last year. Recently, I shared with you guys a couple of videos ago that King Yahusha had received his crown, and that's why he had the title King. And recently as well, Prophetess Deborah Michaela, she also received her crown. She had a dream, and in the dream, she was crowned. and given, I'm not sure if she was given her cloak, but anyway, she was crowned as well. After this, armor bearer Uriel Thomas as well, he received his crown. Now this was confirmed. It was confirmed through a king and prophetess. And shortly after, worship leader Arya Carissa also received her crown, and that was also given to her through a dream and confirmed by king and prophetess. So we are beginning to receive our crowns, and with the crown, you receive your title as king, queen, prince, or princess. I'm happy to announce that Uriel Thomas received the title of prince, and worship leader Ariel Carissa received queen as well. Before, when I showed you this diagram here, you see at the bottom, and I explained the olive trees, the two olive trees, and the priests, the seven priests who make up the menorah, and you have two menorahs, so that's 14 leaders and the two olive trees. And I was explaining that these leaders here, that they're equally yoked, the two olive trees are equally yoked between themselves, and the priest in between the menorah are equally yoked, and the menorah is equally yoked with the other menorah, and these two menorahs are equally yoked with the olive trees. But I said in there that the olive trees received the king and queen anointing, but at that time I didn't know that all of the 14 leaders will receive the king and queen title. I didn't know that. But now that we're living our lives and this is what is happening, so now we know. So coming to just update the information, it's not only the olive trees who are anointed as king, queen, prince, and princess, it is also the 14 leaders, okay? So as of now, King Yahushua Samson, Queen, Prophetess Deborah Mikaela, Prince, Armor Bearer Uriel Thomas, and Queen, Worship Leader Ariel Carissa, and myself, Queen Messenger Aliyah Aura, have received our crowns. We've been crowned. We are going to be wearing our new titles as King, Queens, and Prince. And this is something that I hope motivates you, because it is not only for us, it is for all of the leaders, all of the priests who are in his will and doing his work. That's why we're talking about zeal here. Zeal, Romans 10:2. For I bear them record that they have zeal of Yah, but not according to knowledge. Amen. Romans 12, not slothful in business, fervent in spirit, serving the Lord. Yes. Titus 2, who gave himself for us that he might redeem us from all iniquity and purify unto himself a peculiar people, zealous of good works. Isaiah 59, he put on the righteous as a breastplate, righteousness as a breastplate, and the helmet of salvation upon his head, and he put on the garments of vengeance for clothing, and was clad with zeal as a cloak. Amen. And Psalms 119, therefore I love thy commandments above gold, yea, above fine gold. So what I want you to understand is that it is true. All you have to do is believe on Holy Yahushua, and you will be saved. Here, what we're talking about is not just salvation. We're talking about being priests. We're talking about being zealous. We're talking about being first fruits. We're talking about being the witnesses. We're talking about being forerunners. We're talking about being the elect here. Do you see what I mean? And if you consider yourself a part of that group, or if you want to be a part of the group, you need to be zealous and about that work and about that life. We're not preaching works salvation. What we're preaching is what you see here, zeal. If you're given all these gifts, if you're given the title, if you're given your new name and all of these things, that is your seal. Your new name is your seal. If you're receiving these things, then you need to be zealous and going forth and doing obediently the work and bearing good fruit in his holy name. So that's the first thing. If you want to continue going up in these levels, you need to be zealous. So here's just some Bible verses about the crowns. Thou shalt be a crown of glory in the hand of the Lord, and a royal diadem in the hand of thy God. James 1, blessed is the man that endureth temptation, for when he is tried, he shall receive the crown of life, which the Lord hath promised to him that love him.
So here you go again, where we have received our crown of life. I'm not going to read all of these, but I just want you to be aware of when we say crown, we've received our crown. This is what we're talking about. It's not only symbolic, it is an actual crown that is actually put on your head by Holy Yahushua, or is instructed that the Most High Father will instruct someone else, a man or woman of God, to crown you. But either way, it is an actual, it's spiritual, but it is an actual crown being put on your head, okay? At this stage in his name, this is when you, if you have gone through all these steps, this is when you will receive your crown. As I said, everything is different for everyone. I received my crown last year, but just to put it in simple terms for our human brain, we can understand that in the progression of one's maturity, you have to go through these steps or something similar to these steps to arrive here to be crowned. So now let's get to the real meat and bones of it. Okay, so this is the message that I shared with you last week when I was summoned by Holy Yahushua, and he told me that this was important. And I explained to you that what he was saying was he's talking about the process that goes, that we go through in our bodies. It was confirmed by Leland Jones, and I showed and proved that last week, that when we receive our name on the white stone, as you see here on the Bible verse about Joshua that we've talked about, Zechariah 3, verse 3 and 4, when he's talking about activating the writing on the stone, that is us receiving our seal of Yah, okay? The stone is your pineal gland, okay? As you can see here in this verse, where it's talking about you will receive your name on a white stone, that is your seal. And that's why at the beginning of this video, I put sign, seal, deliver, I'm yours. Yeah. Right? That's why. Because just listen to the words. What happens when you receive a package? You sign it. You sign for it. When you're sending a package and you're sending it official mail, you sign it. Okay? So this is literally, this song by Stevie Wonder is literally telling us that our seal and our deliverance is the signature of the Most High Father. And what is he signing? He's signing the name that he gave us. His name that he's giving us is him assigning to us our portion of our inheritance. Ah, praise Yah. That is directly from the Holy Spirit. Praise Yah. Thank you so much. When your father does a will, he writes your name in the will and he says, I bequeath to her this, 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 and this, right? He gives us our name. He names us. When he's writing your name here and when he's activating it, this is your seal. It is his seal that he is placing here. And you are from that time signed, sealed, and delivered. And as Holy Yahushua told me, he said, you have to go through this process to overcome the mark, okay? You can't just be sitting on the fence. You're not going to be able to get through this as a lukewarm Christian. You're not. You have to be zealous. You have to be signed, sealed, and delivered to overcome the mark. Point blank. End of conversation. This process, it is a process. It is not in your mind. This is a message that I received November 19th, 2018. Guys, 2018, I received this message. And it said, you guys are too mental. It is in your body, not your brain. And I didn't understand it at that time. But what I understand now, when he said it, we know that the kingdom of heaven is everything above the solar plexus, right? He's not talking about returning to the promised land in your brain. He's talking about salvation. Salvation is not in your brain. It is in your entire body. This process of salvation. Again, this is Holy Spirit. This is not me. I'm getting this information the same time you are. Thank you, Holy Spirit. The process of salvation is not in your brain, it is in your body. So that's how I know this stuff is real. As I've said before, when Holy Yahushua summons me, I feel it in my body. Stop thinking so much. You can just think and think and think and think and think, and you're sitting on the couch and just thinking yourself to death, and meanwhile you ain't done nothing. You ain't done nothing. You just sat there and thought away a few hours. You need to be moving in action, okay? And that's when you're going to understand. So we have to, in order to overcome sorrows, you have to ascend to the 7th, the 8th, and the 9th, okay? And the only way you can get up that high is to use your seal, which is the key of David, to get there, which is his name. Okay, and that's the playlist. That's what we're doing right now. Okay, and when he said at the end here, I am the Alpha and the Omega, the first and the last, I had no idea. I was just writing down. But after we looked at Leland Jones' video last week, and he explained that that is his sign. That is his name. When he said, I am the Alpha and the Omega, the first and the last, that is him signing this message right here. Okay, I learned that afterwards. After I saw the Leland Jones video, just like you did last week, okay? He signed it right here. I am the Alpha, Omega, the first and the last. That was not me, okay? That's him. So please take this to prayer. Understand what is being said here by Ruach HaKodesh and get into action. It is in your body. What does this mean? What it means is that you need to clean up what you're eating. We don't eat pork. Why don't we eat pork? Because one, it says in the word to not eat pork, it's unclean. But more specifically, I personally do it because of the verse where Holy Yahushua delivered a man possessed by demons, and the demons said, legion, he said, please, what are you going to do with us? Please send us into those pigs. And so Holy Yahushua sent legion into the pigs, and the pigs ran over the cliff. So what I've understood over time, I think it was Prophetess who brought this to my attention, unclean spirits like pork. They're able to dwell in pork. So that's why I don't want to have any pork in my body. It's like a door where they can use to come in through what's in your body. If pork is unclean and they're able to dwell inside pork and you're eating pork, well, you're opening a door. So you need to be very vigilant on your diet, have a clean diet. You need to be vigilant on your portals, your eye portals, your ear portals. You cannot be listening to worldly music. Worldly music at this point is just filled with demons and devils, all of it. When you're singing a song, you're calling demons or angels. It depends on what you're singing, but if it's not of the Father, you are tap dancing on the line of hell, okay? That music is incantation for evil spirits, and you're opening yourself up. You have to be careful what you listen to, what you watch, the movies, the violence. That is not nothing. That's something. You got to be careful with what comes out of your mouth. We have power in our mouth. You have to be physically doing some kind of exercise. This is your vehicle. This is your vehicle. You need to be overcoming the seven deadly sins, which includes gluttony. You need to deny yourself, deny your flesh. Here's another story. When I first started doing the Sabbath, I had to change who I was. So on Friday, I said I wasn't going to drink and I wasn't going to smoke because I wanted to honor the Sabbath, right? And at first it was a challenge. Friday night would come, the Sabbath, the sun would go down, and I'd be drinking my last drink and smoking my last cigarettes so I could fast from cigarettes and alcohol from Friday night to Saturday night. So I had a complete change of life from Friday night to Saturday night. And I started to notice a big difference between how I was living on the Sabbath and how I was living the rest of the week. And I got to the point where I was like, this is so ridiculous, Father. I would like to be the way that I am on the Sabbath all the time. And that took maybe a year or so to get through. But I did it. And now the way I am on the Sabbath is the way I am all week. You need to be getting to that point where you are denying your flesh, you are fasting, you are doing these things. You're not doing these things because it says in the Bible to do it. I mean, yeah, Yeah, we're doing it because it says to do it in the Bible, but that's our instruction. But we're not doing it because we're told to do it that way. We're doing it because you understand that your body is the temple for the Most High Father. You understand that your body is your spaceship to get out of here. And you understand that this process of going up involves your seals being opened and cleaned, and this is your key, and this is how you're going to get your name, this is how you're going to get your titles, this is how you're going to get your gifts and your powers, and all of these things depends on your body, not only your spirit but also your body. You cannot think your way through this process. So I pray that you understand. The next important part is that you must understand that when we're talking about chakras, because I say the word chakras and everybody runs for the hills like, oh, it's new age. No, listen, priest, please understand. This is your body. Does it not say in scripture that our bodies are the temple of the Most High Father? Yes or no? Yes. Okay. So that means that everything that is in my body belongs to the Father. Okay. Many believe, and I believe as well, that what people call chakras are your glands. So the pituitary gland, your pineal, your thyroid, your thalamus, your pancreas, your ovaries or testes, and your adrenals, these are your chakras. These are the energy points. They are your glands. Okay, this is an actual biological function in our body that Father has put here. It does not belong to the evil one. So please stop giving what belongs to the Father to the evil one. And right now, in Yahushua Mashiach's holy name, I rebuke that wickedness. You are of the Most High Father, and everything in you is of the Most High Father. And these glands are what we are calling chakras. So please do not let the enemy steal your crown because you're getting hung up on his lies. This is a picture that Queen Prophetess gave to me. But I myself have added here the light, lightning, ether, the ruach, oil, fire, the living waters here, the blood and the wine. So you can see that this is about our Father's prayer, our Father, and this is the crown in heaven, the third eye, hallowed be thy name, the throat chakra, your kingdom come, the heart chakra, your will be done on earth as it is in heaven, the solar plexus, give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. And this one down here is, and lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. If you can see how this fits each chakra, and I'm going to play you a recording right now that explains how we understood this information. It comes from priest Ezekiel Daniel David.
Shalom, sis. Okay, so for this recording, I'll talk through the elements and what the Father told me. So this is on the 28th of October. It was at 1:29 p.m. I was just speaking to the Holy Spirit. We were just in prayer and just in conversation. I was asking about weapons in the spirit, so like our spiritual weapons that we can use for spiritual warfare. And earlier that week, the Father started to give me elements that we needed to be filled with. So I was finding that at one point earlier that week I was filled with the lightning, or it was like 2 weeks ago I was filled with the lightning, and then the Lord told me that I needed to be filled with the light, the living waters, the oil, the fire, and the spirit, which is the ruach or the breath. So that's kind of how it started. And then on the 28th was when the Father kind of made it more, so I was being filled with these elements. So I just asked, Heavenly Father, in the name of Yahushua Mashiach, would you please fill me with your fire? And so then I would just say, I receive, and then I would just sit there in the meditation, just receiving the fire, and you know, each element, the water, the air, the ether, etc., would be coming in. Well, the ether was actually on the 28th when the Father told me about it. So then the Father told me that each of these elements, so the living waters, that's connected to the root chakra, and then the fire was connected to the sacral chakra, and the oil was connected to the solar plexus, and then the Father told me that the ruach was in the heart chakra. Then he said that the ether was in the throat. So first he told me the ones that I knew, which was the lightning and the light. So the lightning is the third eye, and then the seventh was the light, which is the crown. And then he talked about being filled with the blood as well. And so then the Father told me that the blood of Holy Yahushua, to be filled with the blood, is the ninth level. And when I was doing the meditations previously, I kept hearing wine, and I just thought, I'm just having a joke here. Wine, come on. I mean, surely not, right? And so then Father did confirm that it wasn't just me. It's just, yeah, the eighth level is the wine, and so the fifth level, which is the throat chakra, is the ether. And so we are to be filled with these nine elements, which are, again, the root chakra is the living waters, the sacral chakra is the fire, the solar plexus is the oil, and the ruach is the heart. The ether is the throat, the lightning is the third eye, the light is the crown, the wine is the eighth level, and the blood is the ninth level. Now, the reason why I found out about there being nine seals was because I was currently battling with a spirit, and I commanded them to tell them what their assignment was, and they said there were nine of them, and I said, well, what's your assignment? And they were like, well, our assignment is to break the seals. And I said, okay. And so I knew from previously before that the seven chakras were seals inside of us, that they were portals. So if they're broken into, the enemy can come in through these portals, which is why then Father confirmed this, that our Holy Spirit confirmed this, that that this is how the enemy has perverted it with the New Age and with the Kundalini, which is why like things like yoga and stuff is really dangerous, because you're starting to mess with these chakras, and so you're perverting them and you're opening them to the enemy, which is dangerous. We're not meant to be doing this. And so this is why with things like yoga and with the Kundalini spirit, which is what you're doing, is you're opening up your seven chakras. This allows for the enemy to, people do get special power, shall we say, or things happen when you do this enough of a practice, but it's the enemy's perversion of what Father is meant to be doing. So we're not meant to be doing that sort of thing. We're just meant, you know, this is completely different, because it's coming from the Lord himself. So you just have to make sure that you are sealing those things, because by being filled with each element, it allows for the Father's energy to fill that chakra, and for it to be properly in alignment, is what I'm understanding from it at the moment. Then on the 31st of October, somewhere between the 31st and the 1st, I'm not 100% sure which one it was, but then the Lord, we start talking about our different aspects of ourselves, etc. And then the Lord told me that there was actually 12 seals. So there's the 8th and the 9th level, and then there's the 10th, the 11th, and the 12th. And they're all seals as well. And so what I got for these seals, the 10th seal was faith, and then the 11th seal was hope. But it's just not any hope. So what the Lord, what the Holy Spirit led me to was 1 John 3:2-3, which says in the King James Version, "Beloved, now are we the sons of God, and it doth not yet appear what we shall be. But when we know that, when he shall appear, we shall be like him, for we shall see him as he is. And every man that hath this hope in him purifieth himself, even as he is pure. So what the Lord was showing to me, or Holy Spirit was explaining to me, is that the hope that we need to be filled for the 11th seal is that when he shall appear, that we shall see him as he is, and that we shall be like him, because this hope purifies us. And so that's, we need to be filled with this hope for the 11th seal. And then the 12th seal is agape, which is love. So it's the love of God. So we need to be filled with the love of God, because it's the love of God that transforms us. And so we have to be filled with all 12 elements, of these. So they would go, just to repeat again, the living waters, the fire, the oil, the ruach, the ether, the lightning, the light, the wine, the blood, the faith, the hope, and agape love, is the 12 that I got. Please check the last three, because I know you had confirmation for the first 9. I'd quite like for you to also get confirmation for the last three. That's it, really. From my understanding, is these are the 12 seals that we need to be filled with.
Okay, so now that hopefully that is clear right here, and we're going to come back and talk about that more next week. Also, I want to play two recordings for you that explains how we are to use the key of David from Prophetess and Armor Bearer.
was receiving very specific instruction in his dream, okay? And to rebuke and to bind and to send back anything that had entered our gates, okay? The gates are within. Anything that had entered our gates, we were to rebuke, bind, expel, and send back to the portal in which it came from in the blood of the Lamb. You must mention and believe on the blood of the Lamb. And so this was the instruction Father gave last night. I had gone to bed in prayer and not realizing that he was going to show me further detail on this instruction that he had given to Priest Uriel Thomas. He was showing me last night after he gave me the vision of the keyhole, and he said, yes, this is what you are to do. The priests that are answering their call, okay? Because remember, priests, many are called, but few are chosen. We must do the work. We must, firstly, he says, we must acknowledge what we have not surrendered fully. We must acknowledge it and understand that it is not of the Father. Any of the cardinal sins, you must acknowledge it to the throne and surrender it. After having done so, and you're doing your calling, you're doing your studies, you're doing your homework, you're doing your research. And I apologize again, I have to give this instruction thoroughly. This is very important. Father is giving us the tools in which we will need to cast out and send, return to sender on these cardinal sins, these spirits, these demons. We must know how to do this. So vocally, you will say it in such a manner that you say, and just an example, this is new to me, you will cast it out. You say something to the effect of, I bind, rebuke, and expel you, and I command you by the blood of the Lamb to return to the portal in which you came from. I declare this by the authority given to me by Father Yahuwah. You are vanquished. You are gone. You are no longer present in my life. Lastly, priest, I can't recall where, I believe it was in the menorah when Father gave me words, impromptu words also. We were in mid-conversation, I believe it was there again, and Father gave me the words, fire proceedeth out of your mouth. Oh, it was with the priestess, worship leader, Ariel Carissa. Yes, Father gave us the words that he would give us, he would grant us the words to speak, that fire proceedeth out of your mouth. Fire proceedeth out of your mouth. Holy is Yahushua.
Okay, so the way our sister was saying it, that's the way you're supposed to say it, sister. Like, you know, you say, Father, never give me the key of David, and please show me. And he shows you the portals, and then after that, when he shows you the portal, that's when you gotta plead the blood of Yahushua Mashiach and send the enemy back into that portal and close the door. Close the gates with the key of David. Say, Father, heaven, I'm gonna close the gate of the key of David. I'm closing the gate. I'm pleading the blood of Christ over it, and to close the portals. And you know, Father was the instruction, the Holy Spirit will guide you through it. You know, so that's the way how I did it, and that's the way he made me close all the gates. And also, it's kind of weird because when I was doing that, the Holy Spirit was pointing like where the borders was at on my hand, but I was having my hand out, pulled out like that, holding the key. And he would, like, the Holy Spirit would just point out where my, where the borders at. And that's when, once the Holy Spirit points where it's at, that's when the Holy Spirit tells me to close, and I close it. Then I just pray over it and say, the gate is closed, Father in heaven, when you close it, and I plead the blood of Yahushua. And you got to keep on pleading the blood of Christ over it, because the gate is already closed. So, oh, man. But the Holy Spirit will guide you through it, sister, because everybody's different. But that's the way how Father gave
it. So there you go, priest.
in closing, I just want to sum up what we've talked about in this video and over the past months that we've been learning these things, even actually the past few years. That's why I'm just begging you, if you're new to this channel, to please catch up so you can fully receive the blessings of this information directly from the Most High Father, His Son, Holy Yahushua, and His Holy Spirit, Ruach HaKodesh. We talked about this TV show, Lock and Key, on Netflix, and we broke it down, and you can see this key is in Him. Do you see this? We've also talked about on Lock and Key. Here, on this picture right here, Lock and Key. If you remember, at the beginning of this playlist, we were talking about His name being the Alpha and the Omega, and here the key is made of the Alpha and the Omega when you line it up with the picture I had drawn of His name, because I was commanded to write His name. Do you remember we were talking about all of this representing your seal, representing the portals inside of you? And now we understand that this is representing your chakras. It's representing your portals inside of you, your glands, okay? Just like the pineal gland, right? And now we understand even better, as Holy Yahushua said to me on October 30th, that this process cannot be neglected. It is your seal of Yah. I speak to you in terms you can relate to. Tell them that the 7th, the 8th, and the 9th can only be opened with your seal, which is the key, which is your seal, which is His name. And He is the Alpha and the Omega. Can you see that's what we have learned? This is your seal. Do you see this right here? This right here is His seal. And the key right here is the name of Holy Yahushua. He is opening the seals right now. Do you see? These are your seals, okay? And I saw in the right hand of Him that sat on the throne a book written within and on the backside sealed with seven seals, Revelation 5:1. These are the seals that He is opening. He is delivering us. Signed, sealed, and delivered. Signed with His name, Alpha and the Omega. Our seals. When He opens us, we are delivered. Do you understand this? And now we have been given the key of David. This is the key, His name. We've been given the key of David, and now we're told how to use it. We're told that we have to be filled with the fire, the oil, the living waters, the ruach, the ether, the lightning, the light, the blood, and the wine. Everything that we have been studying all this time. So here, how to use the key of David. You must pray, Father in heaven, give me the key of David, and please show me where the portals are. There's portals in your bodies. There's portals in your city. Wherever they are, show me where they are. I bind, rebuke, and expel you, any spirit that is not of Holy Yahushua, and I command you by the blood of the Lamb to return to the portal from which you came. I declare this by the authority given to me by Father Yahuwah. You are vanquished. You are gone. You are no longer present in my life. I close these gates with the key of David, and I plead the blood of Christ over it so that it will never be opened again. And I declare this prayer brought to pass, manifested in belief and faith and trust in the name of Holy Yahushua, we pray. Amen. And this work has to be done fervently and zealously, priest. Please understand that. You must close every gate, every door, and clean yourself. And this is the way that you will escape all these things that are to come. So next week, we will go back into talking about how do we make sure that we're filled with all of these elements here. I pray that this has been clear. I pray that you're blessed. In Yahushua HaMashiach's holy name, we give Him all praise, glory, and honor. Amen. All right. Lots of things to talk about. I will come back next week and we will dig more into this information and keep going forward. In the meantime, do what you have to do to clean yourself so that you will be able to continue going up these levels. I am this perfect day, and within me, the light which does not fail dwells. All glory, praise, and honor to the Most High Father. Love you in Christ, priest. Have a blessed day. Shalom.